day 2 of Palm Beach Atlantic University's Welcome Week. The university is set up this week with a lot of events to help the freshmen get used to the campus, help us learn the ropes, and have fun so we're not so nervous. There are competitions and side quests where the student groups compete to win Welcome Week. Points are given Harry Potter style and can be won by winning competitions, getting the president or elect staff to sign your fish hat, matching a crazy freshman story to a senior student who is running Welcome Week, or similar mini-quests. Also, don't lose your fish hat. You have to wear it with pride. If you're caught without your fish hat or like place it on the ground, your team can lose points. And if you should lose your fish hat, you'll have to complete a challenge on stage to get it back in front of everyone. All in all, a lot of fun. New students are grouped into teams, or fish groups. Fish groups are the subgroups that fight for the title of winners of Welcome Week. My group and I are meeting to discuss our plans. We need a group costume theme for tonight, as well as prepare for the lip-sync competition later this week. The lip-sync competition is the Welcome Week grand finale, and it is the event of the freshman Welcome Week experience. My fish group is reviewing past performances for inspiration and ideas. Fish groups go head-to-head, performing on-stage lip-syncing choreography and mouths to a song or series of songs, basing it off of some kind of theme. The fish group decides on their own theme and makes their own props and costumes. Some groups make up a plot while others might tell a story or borrow a plot from a film or a show or something, recreating iconic scenes. Performances come in a variety of quality levels, but above all, this isn't meant to be Broadway. This is just a way to meet people, have fun, and maybe try something new. Still, some of them aren't half bad. One team did what I assume was based off of the film Annie. Another did a Lion King theme. This fish group was really creative with the props and backgrounds. The audience really seemed to like this one. More furries. Considering each fish group had less than a week to script and choreograph this, not to mention props, costumes, and practice, these turned out pretty good. They're still a little cringy, but that's the name of the game, I guess. Also, I'm not gonna lie, some of these lip syncs were downright really good. Fish group has decided to go with a Harry Potter theme, much to my excitement. I volunteered to be Dumbledore before the decision is even made.
I told him he can just ride the unicycle as much as he wants.
If we do Harry going through the wall, it may make more sense, just even if it's a single cutout.
I was gonna hold the sorting hat.
The sorting hat, which is just a fish hat.
I can't wait for the Yoda boy.
Instead, someone's gonna pull out a cowboy
hat. What's my favorite?
He's my crush.
No, me too!
I have a huge crush on Ron Weasley.
Yeah,
he's riding off on a broomstick with Ron Weasley all day.
The lip-sync competition isn't for a few days, it's at the end of Welcome Week, but tonight is the group costume competition. Our team, like many, decided to use the same theme for both the costume competition and the final lip-sync competition. Before too long, the campus empties as students gather into the gym green complex to see which fish groups will win the best costumes and gain points towards winning Welcome Week. Me and my fish group went to a local thrift store and picked out our Harry Potter costumes, or at least what could fly for Harry Potter costumes. I couldn't find appropriate Dumbledore costumes, so I ordered it online. Problem is, it won't come till tomorrow. Thankfully, the rest of my team is properly in garb.
And now, the winners! These are gonna be the winners! I don't have a costume yet. Come tomorrow.
I don't know what that was either. But now, the first fish groups are heading on stage to strut their costumes.
B6 and B7 can be heading back. That would be awesome. See what they are. You guys look a little sleepy. Going onesies.
We're B9, and we're the number onesies.
They're number onesies. Oh my goodness. What is this? What do we have here? Is this B7?
Shh. How many of y'all seen any ducks around here?
Honestly, why is it always The Office? That fandom is more crammed down your throat than Rick and Morty.
How original.
Peace. Battlestar Galactica.
No! God!
My team, W10, is almost up, so we're sneaking to the backstage. Problem is, I thought someone was filming for me, which they weren't, so I don't have any footage of me and my team. I spent a long time trying to find some, a long time. Thankfully, I could recreate the scenes with the miracle of modern technology. So, me and my team walk on the stage in all our costumes, except me and the other guy who walk up in our street clothes, and the announcer is all like,
"Oh. It's Harry Potter and his gang of douchebags."
And I'm like, "Yay, Harry Potter!" And the announcer's then like looking us up and down, and she's like,
"What the hell? Where is your costume?"
And me and the other guy are like, "Yeah, we're muggles, bro, yeah!"
At least he has a sign that says muggle. I literally just walked off the street.
Oh, I don't get Harry Potter references because I am not a wicked Satanist who will burn in hell. Mark 9:48.
And I'm like, yeah, muggles! I realized this was my one shot at fame. I had secretly snuck the Duck Dynasty Duckaroo that I caught onto stage, unknown to everyone. I held it up, pointing at it, then the crowd, preparing to throw it.
Wow. I did not expect a surprise return of one ducky boy.
The crowd went wild. Everyone wanted this quacky fellow, and I was like, you want it? And they're all like,
yes.
And I'm like, here you go! Everyone loses their minds and throw the ducky into the crowd. After the costume event, we start heading downtown. I'm curious to see what's up for tonight. I grew up near DC-ish, but having spent the last eternity in the middle of nowhere, Ohio, the sights and sounds of West Palm Beach are pretty exciting. PBA has rented a local venue center just for the students. They call this event Rockin' Bowl, which I'm pretty sure they stole from somewhere else. I'm be real and admit that I've never done anything like this. I'm excited, not nervous, but I really don't know what to expect. I guess the venue took the Bud Light party things and filled them with soda to make the kids feel like they were at, like, a club or something. It's soda, I swear. This is a Christian server. I mean, club. Jokes aside, this is kinda cool to have the bar party environment without worrying about all the meth heads or getting groped or something. After all, we don't want to scare the homeschoolers here. I was actually homeschooled.
Perfect!
My team's gonna win, W13.
Her team says she's gonna win, but we're gonna win first.
I'm sponsoring W13.
Not sponsored.
Yes, sponsored.
We're winning.
No, we're third place, we're winning.
It seems this place is like a restaurant, bowling alley, bar, arcade thing. Each student gets free arcade tokens on their student card. I'm kicking myself for only realizing this later.
Thank you. That should have been a strike. That really should have.
I know.
I might be, and I hate that. But I never wanted to be a vlogger, but I think I am now.
Nice.
Yeah, just leave me hanging.
I know this is naive to say when classes haven't even started, and I don't want to judge this university prematurely, but I think I might end up really liking it here.